So ideally we want it to be kind of tight. Just enjoy fight lah. Really just enjoy fire. Hi guys, so welcome back to another episode of Jives Fishing. So today we are at Punggol Waterfront. Yeah, it is Sunday lah, so it's a bit crowded. Yeah, so we are at a place closer to the marina. Yeah, so anyway, today we'll be trying out a new bait. Yeah, it's called chicken liver. Yeah, because we heard it's been quite effective for things like catfish, like stingray and grouper. So we're gonna try it out and hopefully we catch something. Other than that, we have live prawn and kelong sotong. Yeah, so we'll probably fish until at night, hopefully. Yeah, so we'll see how things go and update you guys again later.
Can.
Oop, something on the hand line. Oh, yo. Wow. Not bad size eh. Chermin.
Oh, just put down on you.
I don't know how it's hooked. Oops.
Sorry. Oh, that one not bad size eh. On the side only though. just up.
Yes! Wow. Hello! Oh, this one not bad.
Wow, barely on the side.
Yeah. Okay, so here is our Chermin Diamond Trevally Electis Indicus. Yeah, so you can see now it's about last light. Yep. So this one is about over 30 cm, so I'm going to keep it. Yeah, we already bled it and strung it up on the hand line to bleed. So now I'm just going to cut it. Yeah. So anyway, we will keep fishing. Update you guys again later. Hey guys, so now is after last light. At last light about 7, 6 plus 7. Yeah, almost dark. We had that chermin, about 30 cm chermin. Yeah, so we kept it to eat. That one was on live prawn. We haven't started using chicken liver yet. But now that it's dark, we are going to start baiting up our chicken liver. Yeah, so we'll show you how to bait it up. We'll show you our rigs, our setup, I guess. Yeah, so just stay tuned and we'll update you guys again later.
Hey, something on.
I don't know.
Should be have. Small fish. Something small on.
No. Oh, strange. Okay, now. Alright, so here we have our chicken liver on our size 1 hook, double Apollo. Yeah, so what I'm gonna do is basically the same as how I bait anything else. I go through once. Oh, it's quite thick. Okay, yeah, I go through once and then I go through again. Double hooky. Oh, it's actually really quite thick. Okay. And the second one up here. I don't know if we'll need to bait thread these. Honestly. Oh, actually need. Yeah, it will tear. Okay. So anyway, chicken liver is pretty soft. So I think I will need to put bait thread on this. Yeah. So likewise, I will start from on top. Wrap a few rounds and just go. Yep. So ideally we want it to be kind of tight. Where's my point? So you just wrap a few rounds to make sure it doesn't come out. Because chicken liver, as you can see, the bait thread is really biting into it. Yeah, so it's quite a soft bait. So that's one. And the second one. So again, start at the top. Go a few rounds. And then we just... So the reason we wanted to try chicken liver is because it's cheap and it's nicely... It comes nicely in one piece by one piece. Yeah, so it's really cheap. It's like how much?
$1.
Yeah, $1 for like one bag or something. Yeah, so, and we heard it was effective for certain species of fish, so we're going to try that out. Yeah, so there's another bait here. Yep, okay, so we cast this out and hopefully something eats it. Okay, so we're going to cast out the chicken liver. Yes, double Apollo size 1 hook chicken liver. Wow, it looks delicious. I will eat it if I'm a fish. Got one bite. Never mind, I won't kena him. Oh. Wow, not bad. Yep. So just gonna let it sink down, then we'll set it. We'll lose track. Put a bell. Hopefully something comes along and yeah, we'll update you guys again later. Alright guys, so just a quick update. There has been absolutely zero bite. It's not just the chicken liver's fault lah, it's everything. Our sotong, our live prawn, our chicken liver are all not touched. So I think
decided to just change to chicken liver and just leave it.
Yeah, so basically this rig is a small fish rig lah. We tie on our ultralight sotong setup. Yeah, so it's just an Apollo with 4 hooks basically. I think you all seen us use in quite a few of our videos lah. Size 6 tiny hooks. Yeah, maybe try to get some.
It's a size 6 hooks. So you see it's very small.
Yep.
Yeah. This is probably in some small like dosa.
Still can
use a
good fight.
Small. Okay, 3 kV with actually the line here is 10 pound.
10 pound line.
Yeah. Then we have a 20 pound leader. Yeah. Then this is a Storm Adventure.
Yep.
UL. Actually the line is supposed to be 2 to 6 pounds. Yeah. Yeah.
So anyway, we just gonna bait like tiny pieces
back to the chicken
liver. Hopefully get like tosa.
Yeah lah.
Good fight what, not right?
Yeah lah, we've heard tosa,
jahan,
duri.
Why not jahan? Jahan will eat this one.
Jahan and stuff right. But the hook will be small.
Yeah, a bit small. Never mind lah. Imagine like 1 kilo jahan on this. Quite fun.
It'd be fun enough.
You will still fight.
Feel better than the zero fighter.
Yeah, that's why we are using a small setup.
Yeah, anyway, the chicken liver. I think I've shown it in the intro already, but yeah, this one I bought from RedMart, $1 only. So you just search chicken liver RedMart.
Nice.
$1 for one whole packet lah.
Cheap
then
bit.
I just put in the ziplock bag. Yeah.
Nice cheap bit. Can use
and
a lot of times.
Sometimes even when you're buying meat, right, the store owner might, the butcher may give you chicken liver for free also. Yeah, because sometimes people don't want lah. But the same thing like muscles, this one is very
fragile,
so we have to use
to
this bait trap
to thread it. Oh, this one 4 hook, now I regret. 4 hook.
Okay, how about you just thread two of them?
No, I'll thread all.
First, we're also not casting hard.
Okay, that's true. Yeah, la, thread the bottom few. It's very, very soft. Yeah, you can see la, it's almost coming off the hook. Eh? So you just like wrap a few times. Hopefully, it stays on. Okay, yeah, actually, this one. If it's ultralight, maybe you can get away with treading a bit. Yeah.
Tread a bit okay already lah. Chicken liver actually...
When it's frozen, it's actually quite...
It's still a bit frozen.
Yeah, when it's frozen, it's... No, this one is dropping.
Okay, this one is dropping, yeah.
So we probably gonna have to tread these. Ayo. Oh, the juices are coming out. Yeah la. So I heard this is good for jahan because of the juice.
Yeah.
Jahan, pari, maybe gao, maybe grouper. If we lucky, maybe grouper. Okay, la, just tie it on. I think I just thread all in case.
Nah, I can't really.
Okay, lo. Yeah, don't talk about it. I don't care about it.
Just cast off.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, the juice came out.
Oh shit, did you hear your face?
Yes.
Oh no, okay, I get you a face white.
There is one disadvantage of using chicken liver. The juice will come out.
on your face.
Okay, so y'all can see this is a triple hook Apollo size 1. Yeah, so I went from double hook to triple hook. I'm going to put chicken liver on all of these. These are surf cast rod. Yeah, it's a active surf, phantom surf with
Shimano active cast.
Shimano active cast. Then it's a 30 pound line. Yeah, 30 pound line. So the rig line also 30 pound. Size 6J sinker. Yeah, so I'm going to chicken liver all of these because it's been very, very quiet. Yeah, so I'm just going to spam a lot of baits. If not, maybe we'll try to downsize to a smaller hook. Yeah, and we see how things go. Hopefully something will eat this. This hook is actually not very big, size 1, you can see on my finger. Yeah, so anyway, we'll keep fishing. Update you guys again later.
Can come in on. Wow, you really. Ooh. Wow. Yeah, just enjoy fight lah. Really just enjoy fight lah. Bopian. I really. Slowly lah. Get footage on.
This is on liver right?
Yeah.
What the hell?
How the chicken liver?
Since when chicken liver?
Like on the small rod.
Then we buy the
sotong. You wanna go there? Yeah, I think you walk there.
Then we buy all the sotong.
Walk there lor, walk there. Careful got hand line. The rod a bit bendy. Yeah. Go under him. Sorry. Thank you.
Big job.
Huh? Come in here. If I don't directly high stick up.
Chicken liver, the test success.
Yeah, but the rod is a bit sad.
You take the lightest rod as always.
Yeah, I always like that one.
It's very sweet.
You can put chicken liver on soft cast. Oh. You can or not? I go and fix. Huh? Oh, I just film. Huh?
Just film first.
Okay. Oh. For the bloody bush. Wow.
What?
You just bend, I thought it's a crack. Then after our other rod also start to give problem. So I thought it was that guy. Then he start to struggle, then I'm like, eh.
Yes, sir, when you say crab, then the drag suddenly go.
Ah, it suddenly go right, that's why I like, eh. That is not a crab.
Thank you.
Ada, ada. Size 6 hook.
We okay, landed on a size 6.
To the side. Confirm nothing here. Confirm. I can wear this. Setting.
Ah, nice one. Okay, so we are 10 already, 0 kilo.
Oh my god, I broke your thing.
Am I? Okay, so off the ground. And 6.2, yeah, 6.1, 6.2. Okay.
I broke your thing.
Okay, the weighing scale is broken.
Let's go, let's go. Oh my god. You're here also.
And mine. This. whatever.
Maybe more than that, you don't know also.
Yeah,
you
maybe,
got it there, then you
maybe
break.
It's more than this, just that we don't know.
You split that into half. Eh? Alright, guys, so this is what happened to our gaff. It's absolutely destroyed and tangled. Yeah, with our rig. So you can see our rig. And this is the hook that landed the 6 plus 6 something kilo stingray. It's just a size 6 hook. Yeah, with chicken liver. Yeah, I am absolutely exhausted. I think y'all can hear me, because it was a whole lot of trouble trying to get the rig up. And yeah, basically impossible to release him. The gaff. Yeah, he just went around our line. Then he hit the ray like 2 or 3 times. Afterwards, I had to manually drag the ray up the Marina Country Club there, the slope. Yeah, so I'm actually very, very tired. Okay, so the ray is here. We tried to dispatch it using a knife, but the knife cannot go through because it was too hard. So I think we'll just let it die before we cut it. Yeah, I don't want to cut it when it's alive. Yeah, so update you guys again
Later. Ding.
This all we are keeping for ourselves, just one fillet and another fillet. So this is about two fifths of the stingray, I would say. Yeah, so we just take what we need and then we give away like what we are not using, so that we don't waste the food or stuff. Yeah, we just take one each for us and then we just give the rest of the stingray to the family fishing beside us.
So that was a cowtail whipray or bull ray. Yeah, so this particular species is not threatened yet. Okay, the reason we kept it was because we guffed it. Yeah, and in the end the guff got stuck. But yeah, never mind. It was a very difficult way to bring it up. Yeah. So if it was a threatened species like the leopard ray, for example, in one of our previous videos, yeah, we would advise we let it go lah. And rays of bigger size, so about maybe 10-20 kilo, that kind of size, usually we advise to release, because those are the breeders. Yeah, so those are the rays that we actually breed. And rays have a very long life cycle. Is it life cycle? Is it called life cycle?
Life history.
Yeah, it's called a life history. So rays have a very long life history. It means they grow very slowly, they reproduce very few at a time lah. Yeah, so it's actually advised to release the bigger ones and the smaller ones. If you want to keep the mid-sized ones, are the better to keep size lah. Yeah, but of course if it's a threatened species, then it's best to just release all of them. Yeah, so anyway, some people call this the bull ray. Yeah, I think. Yeah, so they can grow pretty big, 20-30 kilos. Yeah, so it's different from the usual rays we get here. Usually we get blue spotted stingray, we get mangrove whip ray, which look very, very similar to this bull ray. Yeah, so I heard that bull ray prefer muddy substrate over sandy substrate. So I'm a bit curious as to why it's here. Yeah, but anyway, it was very lucky we fought it on our lightest setup, on a tiny size 6 hook that we accidentally hooked into the side of it. Yeah, on chicken liver. Yeah, it's really just, I don't know. Yeah, I'm just very grateful for that. Yeah, so anyway, that's about it. We've packed up most of our stuff and yeah, I guess we have a few rods out lah, so we'll update you guys again later. Okay, guys, so for stingrays, there's two things you need to watch out for. It's the two barbs. Okay, you can see it's very, very big. It's longer than my whole hand. Yeah. So for the bull ray, this is actually at the middle of the tail, not at the end or at the start. Yeah. So you need to watch out for that. It can get you if you touch the center of the disc. Yeah, so for some rays like the mangrove ray, that they are at the closer to the butt of the tail. For some, they are further, like the fantail ray. Yeah, so you just need to take note of these two. These are venomous and they are serrated, so do not get this stuck into your hand or your leg or anything.
And yeah. Dispose of them properly.
Yeah, dispose of them. Like, you will throw it away. Yeah, don't leave it along the waterfront. okay, there are children running around, especially on a weekend. Yeah, so there's a lot of children, there's a lot of people walking their dogs. Please do not leave this kind of thing around, and don't leave fishing hooks around either. Okay. So anyway, just to reiterate, for rays, the best size to keep are actually the mid-sized ones. And of course, non-threatened species. If it's threatened species, I think advisable to just release everything. Yeah, but if it's a non-threatened species, the best size to keep is actually the mid-range ones. Yeah, so the small ones, you can just let go. The big ones are the breeders, so it's actually advisable to release them. Even though sometimes, if possible.
If that one was any like bigger, we probably have cut the line.
Yeah, or we would have tried to bring it, walk it round.
We don't really want to fight anything bigger.
I don't want a huge ray, it's very troublesome. It's really very troublesome. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you guys enjoy yourself. Hope you learn something from this video. And yeah, hope to see you guys in the next episode. Thank you.